This is the Doctor continuing the long war playthrough. It is now the 5th of June, and a large unidentified UFO is headed towards Canada. NOE means it's going to land. I sent up a fighter just to check out what it was, and it's a transport. So, I'm just going to move 4 o'clock, and it landed.
Contact detected.
First, let's do covert operations. Intel scan.
Intel scan complete.
Just the one cell, really?
On Exalt cell location.
Okay. Now, I've been reading about some people using high mobility scouts to good effect on Exalt missions, so I'm going to test out this theory by sending you out. And I'm not going to have you carry any items to maximize your mobility. Let's see if this really is an effective plan. If I lose this soldier, that's okay. I have a number of other scouts, but we'll see. We'll see how this works. This is like 21 mobility. This is going to be realistically as good as it's going to get at this point in the game, so we'll see how this works.
Operative deployed to
nothing new to report right now.
But that's not really interesting. Even if I lose that soldier, it's susceptible.
Contact detected.
This is the real opportunity. Here's the thing. If only this transport had come like 10 days later, I would have squad size 2, I would have 4 carapace armor, I would be in really, really good shape to have a reasonable chance of assaulting and beating it. But it had to come when I was just not ready. I just need a little bit more time, but that's this game for you. However, I still think it's worth attempting because I could get lucky and I could roll easy enemies. And the loot is so good. If you can seize one of these ships, you get so much loot. It's so ridiculous that it's just like you, unless this happens in like March or April, and if you have any reasonable shot of at least attempting the mission and getting ready, you have to have this mindset to bail if things go wrong. I cannot emphasize this enough, because things can go wrong. If they go wrong, just run. There is no bonus points for staying fighting to the end. In fact, the game punishes you for doing that. Fortunately, they're changing that in beta 14 somewhat. But whatever happens, you know, do not stay and fight to the bitter end. That's stupid. That's pointless. You know, pick off some aliens. Heck, even if I can take out like 3 or 4 pods, I'll get something out of it. Experience, a few artifacts. We'll see. But this is really hard. So I need to bring my very, very best team, and I need to pack a gazillion explosives. So let's see, medic, gunner, engineer, infantry, and I'll bring one of my top snipers. I actually want to bring the sniper with a lot of health, but he's kind of fatigued, right? Yeah. You have no health, but I might be able to keep you safe. We'll see. Alright. So, let us begin. First will come two of my best rocketeers, fresh from their promotions from the Exalt mission. This will give me the awesome firepower of 6 rockets between them. That's my plan for this mission. If I see a pod, I'm just gonna go and blow everything up. No sense in holding back at this point. Sawed-off shotgun could be useful. I'm gonna carry 1 smoke grenade too, because 2 dense smokes could really help me out. Gunner, because I will run into Cyberdisks, and this is the way you beat Cyberdisks. This is gonna go on the sniper. I think an AP grenade is actually good in case I run into, I mean, it's not in case, when I run into. So this soldier, I'll come back to him at the end. Infantry, of course. You're gonna need infantry. Damage is great. Scope. Yeah, it's probably best on the infantry. This soldier does not have lock and load, so I might need the AP grenade. It's a little disappointing, but this sniper has such crazy good aim. I'm actually gonna give you alloy plating so you don't die. I'm gonna give you an AP grenade too. I really wish you could get to 100 aim, but it looks like that's not gonna happen. much more important to have these on the Rocketeers. They cannot, under any circumstances, miss. They have to hit. That's the only way I win this. And then Engineer, I was just going to talk about the perk motion. You can see the first four tiers. Sapper seems like a really obvious choice, but if you really think about it, like, holo targeting is nice, but if you take smoke grenade, you really should take then smoke and smoke and mirrors. Because at this rank, Ranger's not great on Engineer. You're mostly going to be using grenades and doing support stuff. Normally, I'd actually think Ranger is a really good perk on a lot of classes, but just because he doesn't really use his primary weapon, it's not so great. Repair looks great, except at least for this beta, I don't know if they're going to change it for the next one, but Sentinel Drone basically provides all the healing you need of robots. So the only reason to get repair is basically to have more chances to capture aliens, which is good, and gives your economy a nice little boost, but, you know, when you take this, you're basically locked into taking an arc thrower. Now you're down to two grenades, and you can't really do anything else. You're like, throw two grenades, capture an alien. On some missions, you just can't do that. Whereas, if you go for smoke and mirrors, think about what you can bring. Now, suddenly, and this would have been great for this type of mission, now I suddenly get potentially up to two dense smoke grenades, and four damaging grenades. I have six grenades I can just throw around. That's just unbelievably good. And you can do all sorts of stuff later on, like, you know, this stacks with, like, chem grenades and flashbangs, so now you can bring, like, two chem grenades, two alien grenades, or two AP grenades, and you have two smoke grenades. You have six grenades to do all sorts of stuff. You gotta remember, Arc Thrower, for, you know, 90% of the mission, is useless. It's only... it basically boosts your economy a little bit. That's all it does. Whereas, and you have to give up two grenades for this, which could be a problem on a map like this. This is why I'm not convinced, like, you know, because if you don't go for Sapper, it's kinda iffy to go for the grenade path. You can still sort of get this, but then, you know, you're sort of like squandering the potential of this. You might as well go for the repair. So, I think for my next engineer, I brought up two of these guys so I can use the repair perk. For my next two engineers, I think I'll go the smoke grenade, dense smoke, smoke and mirrors path. You do lose holo targeting, which is a bit unfortunate, but scouts can provide that, and I don't think it's absolutely terrible. Last thing is, I actually do want to carry mostly AP grenades. You don't blow up so much cover, whereas there can be lots and lots of chrysalids. Well, actually, no. There are some circumstances where you blow up cover. Okay. I'll go the traditional route. You never know. I did carry a number of other AP grenades around. Yeah. Infantry has one, sniper has one, gunner has one. Alright! This will be by far the hardest mission.
We have visual.
Seven-man squad.
The drop site for this operation will be in Canada.
It's just gonna be hard. You
we
need the eight-man
squad.
To
a landing site in a rural area outside of a small town. We should move to secure the site and clear out any hostiles we can find.
Oh, do not attempt to go for meld on this sort of mission. It's pointless. Literally, if the meld is like two move away, do not go for it because you will trigger a pod, possibly two, and you will die horribly. You cannot trigger more than one pod. Well, maybe. We'll see. So it's this particular map. I actually kind of like this map.
Strike one is ready to move on your orders.
Often, the command pod is this way. So what you want to do is go this way. Furthermore, on this sort of mission, the aliens patrol around a lot. If you just sort of hunker down and bunker down in this starting area, sooner or later, the aliens will come to you. And then, you let loose the rockets, you use like this ridge to your advantage. Alien comes over here, you blow them up. If they come over here, you also just basically alpha strike them. I have dense smoke. Even if I leave my soldiers exposed, it's not the end of the world. So, the plan is simple. We're gonna bunker down. I'm gonna put my rocketeers in good positions.
Поехали. I'm
gonna bunker down. And I am just gonna wait until I take out like four or five pods here. And then we'll think about moving out. I mean, this is, like, boring and, you know, not exciting, but believe me, you cannot move out. Like, you just
moving
can't.
To position. X-ray spotted.
Ugh. Even that little maneuver was really bad. You can see. Okay, this is good. This tells me something really valuable. There are three seekers there. Critically, what this tells me... I don't have any scanners, crap. There is a really good chance, like, even though I'm firing blind, that I will knock out some of the seekers. But the problem is, I don't know if they're flying or not. If I use a normal rocket, I don't know if I'll catch them or not. It's a high-risk, high-reward move, and sometimes on the opening turn like this... I'm also a little worried about not having enough shredder rockets. I could potentially face up to, like, 4 or 5 Cyberdisks, and having a shredder is so useful. Okay, I'm not gonna roll the dice here, but... ugh. But I may regret this.
Jive.
Affirmative. Come on.
Let's see what aliens there are. Cyberdisk, as I expected.
Something out there.
More advanced aliens can roll on this type of mission earlier than they would normally appear. Cyberdisk, they do sort of appear starting around the middle of June. But you can, like, run into Cyberdisk in May. This is good. So I'm gonna hide my troops out of line of sight as much as possible. And then just overwatch everyone. Except you, I guess. You're not gonna hit. If I can take out this pod, I'll feel much better. Come on, Seekers. If I had one more slot, I would almost certainly have brought a scout. Not only for the battle scanners, but because you can use it to bait out the Overwatch shots on Cyberdisk. But I don't have one more slot, and the scout is the most expendable of the bunch. Come on, Seekers. Oh boy. Is the AI really going for a coordinated attack? Because... good job if the AI is going to do that. At least I get an Overwatch wall off on it. Cyberdisk.
Adjusting sights.
Please just be the one Cyberdisk. I can take one. I can't take more than one at once. Please just be the Cyberdisk. No Seekers. But sometimes the AI does good moves. They will coordinate their attacks and I will be screwed. If they coordinate their attack, this is, like, over. This is why these missions are so high risk. Okay, I got lucky and the AI did not coordinate its attack. Let's not get the shot blocked. Landing the right shredder rocket is going to be everything. Why does it say shot block? Okay. This looks good.
Won't even know what hit him.
Step one, shred it. With heat ammo, you blow up all the little drones and you do tremendous damage to the Cyberdisk itself. Ugh! Don't have line of sight on it. Not gonna kill it. Damn, the position of these troops is not the best. I don't want to throw in smoke in case the Seekers come. sort of don't want to blow up the Cyberdisk corpse, but you know what? We can't risk it. The corpse, I can get more Cyberdisk wrecks. What I can't get is all the loot from this mission, so I'm just going to burn a second rocket here, reposition my unit so I don't run into the same problem. One down. Cyberdisk wrecks, rather, are particularly valuable. So I hate blowing them up, but what can you do sometimes?
D'accord.
I didn't even get line of sight from there, but
heading to that location.
This should help. Alright, I still have some rockets left, so that's good. I have 4 rockets left.
Uh-huh.
Where are those seekers? Yeah, lightning reflex chrysalids, but I'm prepared for this eventuality too. Preparation is everything. Where's that last one? Why are there only 3? Well, the last one doesn't look like you can run up and one-shot me. Yeah, don't even think about the meld. That's pointless. I don't think I need a rocket for this. Oof. Let's see how the first grenade goes.
Throwing grenade!
It could be better. I can sawed off that one. That one's probably dead from the sniper. I do have 200%, it looks like, from the Rocketeers. Scope plus carbine, not so bad, huh? That should take out that one. Yeah. Okay, looks like I shouldn't need any more explosives. I wonder where the last one is. Well done, sniper. Well done. That's really good. The minimum row on laser carbine, by the way, is 3, so that one's dead. I could actually just move up here and shoot it with the auto laser and then reload. Actually makes a lot of sense. But I'm actually a little terrified of moving up. What if I reveal another bot? That door just opened. Let's do this.
He's down.
Okay. We're green to go.
Where are those seekers? I don't know why they haven't attacked, but I'm not gonna complain. There's one more chrysalid, and it's hiding. It shouldn't be able to reach any of my troops, so I'll finish it off. There's another Cyberdisk, as I expected. Oh boy! Another group of chrysalids! Look at the insanity on this sort of mission! Okay, I can deal with this. Whew. Let's see. That looks really good. Well done. I don't really care if I blow up any of these corpses. The real loot's not the corpses, but the alloys and all the other good stuff. I have no chance of hitting any of these, basically. But let me think about this really carefully. Okay, the one with 2 health is obviously dead. I could shoot and then grenade. I actually think the best move is to use grenade on the sniper. This is as good of a time as any. I mean, there's no point in saving this. That should kill the chrysalid in the back. Excellent! This is beautiful.
J'ai plus rien à tirer.
Je l'ai eu.
Oh, that took care of 8 chrysalids, Cyberdisk. Where are those seekers? I don't know where they are, but I'm not budging from this location yet. Maybe I will budge just a tiny, tiny bit.
Okay.
Don't know where those seekers are.
Je suis en route.
All right, that's the extent I'm gonna budge.
C'était quoi ce bruit?
Camp the LZ. Aliens aren't the only ones who can use such a tactic. There could easily be... So, there can be up to 8 pods. That includes the command pod, so there are 7 pods patrolling around. I've taken care of at least 3 of them. But that doesn't mean anything. I do have more rockets, in case things go poorly. Which they almost certainly will.
On my way.
I don't know where those seekers are. It's really weird. I'm not gonna complain, but...
Okay, je surveille la zone.
Got it covered.
But it is odd. They're decloaking. Maybe if I move here? Triggers the music, but I don't see anything. They must have some sort of glitch, like they're up there or something. I'm just gonna overwatch everyone again.
Quiet. Did you hear something?
Okay, now the seekers are coming. There were 3 of them. So... Okay. I think holo-targeting persists through the alien's turn, so it makes my overwatches more accurate. Fun fact. I'm not 100% sure on that. We'll see. Oh, turning visible again. Good move. That's not good.
Here they come.
Well, okay, the good news is it's in the fog. So I can dash this soldier out, hopefully without triggering the overwatch. I don't know for a fact, so I'm gonna use a dash move. Not that you're gonna contribute much. Oh, there's a overwatch from that. Ugh. That was a mistake, but minor mistake. I can use paramedic. Let me think. I haven't decided what to do with that sequence of moves yet. You have executioner, okay. You might be able to one-shot it. Worth trying. Boom.
Taken care of.
Good. Now, the Cyberdisk is somewhere over there. There is a reasonable chance it will be able to grenade me. But there's very little I can do about that. I just need to make sure I'm not flanked. I'm gonna put my soldier, who's the toughest of the bunch. Well, that's my medic. Okay. Actually, the officer is the least expendable.
Rub some dirt on it, you wimp.
What I can also do to counter grenades is hunker everyone down. That'll give them at least 1 damage reduction against the grenade. But then again, so will hiding behind that. Better steady aim both of those. Oh, but I just don't want to create, like, such tempting targets. Okay. I don't think the Cyberdisk can throw the grenade all the way back here. And if it can, at least I'll be, like, not in the center of the blast.
Yes, ma.
Yes, I think the best course of action now is to pull back. Let the Cyberdisk come to me. I'm tempted to dense smoke, but that might encourage it to throw a grenade, which I really don't want. I'd rather eat like a shot. There's also a cloak seeker out there, but it's not the real threat. If I can take care of this Cyberdisk, that will be four pods down. Plus, if I take care of the secret pod, that will be five pods down, which is a really good sign. This is not encouraging. Where is the Cyberdisk? This is really not encouraging. It must just be out of line of sight, but there's no other place to retreat to. I can't advance. What if it's on Overwatch? Okay. Drone's not really dangerous. I'm gonna reload.
Chargé et paré.
Hide my sniper sort of in a sneaky position. The drone might be able to get in, but I'll be fine. Let me think. Drone can move like over here. Yeah, that might be able to sneak see my sniper. Damn. I think the best plan now is a little counterintuitive, which is to hunker everyone. Because if the Cyberdisk does decide to throw a grenade, at least I have a really good chance of surviving it. My officer will help prevent people from panicking. And then my next turn, the Cyberdisk is dead. I will counterattack it. And if the heat ammo gunner doesn't get it, then the heat ammo rocketeer will get it. So, defensive stance. Oh, good move. I forgot about that seeker. That's okay. He got a soldier I didn't care about. The Grenadier wasn't going to contribute much anyway. Where the hell's the Cyberdisk? I don't care about these drones. They're trivial enemies. I can destroy them anytime I want. There we go. Okay, I was right about a grenade. Decided to grenade my infantry. You can see how hunkering prevented damage on my soldiers. Do you see that? That was awesome. You may be injured, but paramedic will heal you up a bit. You'll need some time in the infirmary, but it's acceptable. I can deal with the secret later. In fact, if it ends up strangling my engineer for another turn, whatever. Like, not a problem at all. What needs to die is the Cyberdisk, because that if it strangles my engineer for one more turn, he just has like a bit of recovery time in the infirmary. Not really relevant. Okay, I only did 5 damage. No sensing saving a rocket against such a dangerous enemy. We need to kill it now. I just need one hit off on it to kill it. Sniper, can you do it? 75% isn't great. What about you? Okay. Let's try the sniper.
Shot failed to connect.
It's not the end. I have two chances with the infantry. Well done. Only one chance needed. This allows me to use this soldier for a 100% shot to guarantee killing that seeker.
Not a problem anymore.
This allows me to move my medic up to heal.
Don't move, you'll be fine.
So at this point, before I end the turn, let me run a mental tally of what happened.
Good to go.
I've destroyed two Cyberdisk groups and two Chrysalid groups. That's four groups down. There was a Seeker drone group, of which I've killed off the drone, and two Seekers, meaning there is one Seeker left. That leaves three pods, two of which are patrolling, one of which is the command pod. I do not know the composition of said pods. So at this point, I will overwatch. Oh! Gotta be kidding! Another Cyberdisk?! This is what I mean, these missions are insane! Okay, so it's a group of floaters and a group of Cyberdisks plus one Seeker. Well, let's begin by reloading, and then I'll plan out my move after that.
Roger that. Scanning.
Reloaded.
Come get some.
Affirmative. Covering now.
C'est bon. Garçon, laisse-moi me la dire.
Something's even close by. You know what? Could be another Cyberdisk group. I mean, it is another Cyberdisk group, but let us advance slowly but cautiously.
I'm rolling.
Too bad that cover is destroyed. Very unfortunate. But you see how that hunker down was great? Yeah, don't underestimate hunker. Probably should have even hunkered that soldier, but... yeah, now that I think about it, if I had hunkered down there, I would have taken only 3 damage. And I still get 2 shots off on the Cyberdisk, which is the only enemy that matters. The drones are irrelevant. Someone's moving around inside the UFO. I hear doors opening.
I'm rolling.
Again, let's take a look. Didn't trigger anything yet. I like to go, like, patrol around the outside of the map and not heading to the UFO where you can get ambushed. Rather by patrolling around out here, as long as you're careful about it. You have cover and, like, some ability to maneuver. It's not much, but critically, you can't get flanked. Like, if you try to move up here, what if a pod comes from this direction and a second pod comes from the engine room? Then you're dead, so...
move into position.
For now, play the slow and steady game.
Affirmative.
Be sure.
There's something patrolling around. Look, sounds to me like the engine room. Oh, or is it just a Seeker? That kind of sucks. You could get a damaging flanking shot.
Adjusting sights.
Цель не поражена.
Nice job, Corporal Hill. It's the power of heat ammo. Okay, the Seekers are all taken care of. Floaters don't scare me anymore. I am worried about the Cyberdisk.
I'm on it, Commander.
I'll try to move up to this area now. Obviously, if the Cyberdisk comes, I still have 2 more rockets I can use on it. But I'm not going to be super happy. I can now start moving out my troops like this, because...
on the move!
Scouted everything.
Ça bouge.
Looks like there is a reasonable chance of me winning this. at this point is not a guarantee at all, because the Outsider pod is hard. Especially once you burn your consumables, the Outsider pod is really hard. I really wanted to save like a rocket for them.
Got it covered.
If you don't have consumables, the Outsider pod is a nightmare.
Field, Commander.
Reloaded.
Let's rock.
Roger. Roger that. J'y vais tout de suite.
Just gonna wait here patiently.
Position confirmed.
Throw around the map to find the last Cyberdisk group. And then the floater group, once I take care of those two groups, I will take out the command crew. Always save the command crew for last. Okay, this process is not going to be the most interesting. So I will pause the video until I found some more enemies. Alright, and I am back. It turns out Pod of Floaters, while I was moving this way, patrolled around, sort of got me in an awkward position, but my Overwatch wall killed two of them. There's one more in there, which will take it one turn to come out, and this one is in prime position to get flanked. And I can also lock it down with suppression, right? Can I see him from here? The floater might come out through this way and shoot my soldier in the face, which would suck, but... in any event, there are at least two flanking maneuvers I can make against that floater.
So, on my way.
Let's do it. Nice work, officer.
Hoorah!
One floater left doesn't really scare me. My concern is that it attempts to flank my troops. Can't have that. If I hide down here, I should be safe. But I would much rather hide up here.
Heading to that location.
Okay.
On y va.
Just gonna overwatch these, even though it's low cover.
Affirmative. Moving out.
I think it'll be fine.
Come here, son.
Cyberdisk left. It's not encouraging.
Watch.
Ready to rock.
Just gonna wait for this floater to come out. At this point, now I have enough overwatches to probably kill it. I'm not gonna go into that room.
You hear that?
I'm gonna wait for the floater to come out. Like, how am I gonna move up there with cover? There's just no cover. So, once the floater comes out, should be easy enough to deal with. Okay, my Overwatch killed it. Perfect. There is exactly one pod of Cyberdisk left, plus the command pod. Clearly, we want to take out the Cyberdisk before engaging the command pod. Fighting both at the same time is suicidal. So, this is good. I'm going to pause the video until I find the Cyberdisks. Alright, I triggered the last group of Cyberdisks, and it is extremely unfortunate. I split my team up into two. Should have kept the team more closer to this door, but I thought the Cyberdisks might be out here. No, it turns out it was over there, and it snuck around. And this is not good, because my Rocketeers are all out. But this is not the end. This Smoke grenades, even though the graphics show this, cannot penetrate walls, I believe. Unless, like, the grenade lands behind a wall. So, that is a problem. Somehow, this sniper has a shot on the Cyberdisk. So, that's good. I can attempt to shoot the Cyberdisk, but there's no guarantee I will succeed. And if I miss, the Cyberdisk kills me. Which is bad. This soldier is also horribly exposed, which is also bad. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make the first simple move. Do a small amount of damage to the Cyberdisk. Next. Try to kill off some of these drones. I might even get the Cyberdisk to panic. There's a... Then... suppress the Cyberdisk. Now, ideally what happens is the Cyberdisk, like, sort of panics and runs. We can't be sure of that. Next...
Running.
We need to start transferring my troops. Frame rate dropped there for a bit. Suppressing the Cyberdisk seems to have made my computer go much slower. Okay, now it seems a little better. Yeah.
Stepping off.
Now I may have to turn the graphics setting down. Yeah, it looked like that helped a bit. Okay. Kind of. There is something like... Let me pause recording. There's something weird with the video here. Alright, I seem to have fixed the graphics issue. Something about this room in particular. It's not...
Affirmative.
Tempted to use a grenade. My fear with using a grenade is what if, like, the outsiders are over there and this blows up the walls and reveals them. I honestly don't know what the Cyberdisk is gonna do. I usually kill them so fast. Well, that's not good. That's really not good. Okay, it moved. At least I get an opportunity shot on it, but I missed. This is, could be a disaster. It dashed? Okay! Okay! That's like one of the best possible things that could happen. One of the best possible things. I don't know where it is right now, but... this gives me a chance to reposition all my soldiers. I finished off its little entourage of drones, too. Don't want to be too close to the front.
On y retourne.
Don't hide behind the power source, that could blow up. Hiding here would be suicidal. There's not too many places to hide. Like, this position is really the best.
Roger that.
I think this position is still okay. He's unlikely to be able to flank me that quickly. We'll see, though. Being outside is bad, 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 but... what I'm gonna do... I can't get up there, that's also bad. Let me think. Well, outsider could definitely... I mean, not outsider, Cyberdisk could definitely get here. That position was so good. I'm gonna position a rocketeer here in case it tries some sort of sneaky shenanigan.
Stepping off.
Really hope it doesn't come and grenade that position, but at least I'll be able to counterattack and probably kill it next turn if it does that. And you, I am going to hide here, sort of like out of line of sight.
I feel, Commander.
Okay, good. Really needed this. Now I can start positioning my troops much better. Don't know where the Cyberdisk is. This is unfortunately a very awkward place to fight. Without knowing exactly where the Cyberdisk is, like if I move there, I could be flanked. Too many places where I can be flanked.
Position confirmed. Je vais vers la position.
I can't move down there. What if I need the rocket? Hunker you.
I field, Commander.
It's no good place to put you either. Great. All of these positions are too risky.
Copy that. Yamigum.
Got it. Moving.
I hate splitting up my team like this, but without knowing exactly where the Cyberdisk is. Okay, okay, that tells me a good amount. Cyberdisk is likely still moving around there. I don't want to move up to it. I would much rather Cyberdisk come to me. Plus, there's a pod of outsiders. That being said, Cyberdisk is unlikely to be able to flank this position now.
Moving out.
On overwatch.
I feel, Commander.
Huh. Where are they? Well,
on the move.
Probably the best position.
Roger that.
Okay,
Shh. I think I heard something.
Yeah. Okay, okay.
Let's do this.
Too risky. That's good.
Already there.
Sniper will keep a lookout.
Moving to Overwatch. Got it covered.
Just what I do, my dog.
Okay. Should probably hunker that one. Well, the Cyberdisk is over there somewhere.
There's something out there. They're trying to pull back.
Whoa! Destroying my cover! Dangerous stuff. Fortunately, I have more decent cover to hide behind.
I'm on the move!
I'm considering blowing out a chunk of this wall. Make it so that I can attack the Cyberdisk. But then, what cover would I hide behind? There's not really any cover here anyway. Well, at this point, the plan is basically to zerg down the Cyberdisk. I hate plans that involve zerging down stuff. They never work well, but what choice do I have?
Fastball special.
Okay. Not encouraging. Not encouraging either. Not encouraging that I can't see the Cyberdisk from this range. That's more encouraging. If I hit it now, 0% crit? Really? Even though it's exposed like this? Huh. Really strange. I'm not sure if that's actually working as intended. Sometimes you just gotta roll the hard six. Cyberdisk got me in a very bad position, so good for it. But it's not the end. There is unfortunately no place I can position myself where the Cyberdisk wouldn't be able to do damage to me. Ugh. Nice hit. Alright, Flush. Do your thing.
Flush him out.
Oh yeah. Okay, that worked out really, really well for me, thanks to Flush. The ability to do a moderate amount of damage consistently can really save you in certain situations, like this one. And now, there is one command pod, one pod left, which is a command pod, and I have a rocket, which should be fine. So I am going to pause this video until... I also got kind of lucky the sniper didn't get one shot, but a Cyberdisk here, but... it was flying too, so certain amount of luck. Probably should have hunkered the sniper, but yeah. So I'll pause the video for now. All right, this is the Doctor resuming the video. It turns out I took contact in a really awkward spot. I was trying to sneak a sniper up, but she just barely had vision. The pod is over here, and I triggered them, which is unfortunate, but. Especially that the outsider is up there, he can run down and flank me, but it's not the end of the world. I do have troops in position in this command bunker. This is a really good place to bunker down.
On the move.
Aye, aye. I feel, Commander.
Come here, sir.
Honestly, don't know where the outsider is going to come from, so I might as well just overwatch you.
Heading
like
to
here.
That location.
Come get
okay, je surveille la zone.
Hmm. Well, he doesn't appear to be up here anymore. I would really like to concentrate my firepower, but also do have one more grenade
yes,
left.
Commander.
I would also dearly love to be able to snipe something.
Affirmative.
I'm gonna wait one more turn.
Overwatch.
Solid copy.
I also have dense smoke that I can use.
Vous avez entendu?
Ok. Okay. Interesting. They must be hiding out there on Overwatch themselves. What if they're trying to sneak around this way? Can't have that. Might be able to send my soldier out to scout next turn. Ugh, if it weren't for the outsider on the roof, I'd be in a much more commanding position. But as it stands, I sort of have to cover every possible entrance. They seem to be out there. They heal though, which is the really, really irritating part. And there's a thin man. Think it's time to use the smoke grenade. They're starting to get within good range of me. I also have one more HE grenade I can use to like blow a section of the wall and then fight. It's not a bad plan, honestly. One down, four more aliens left. I know one is over there. Or is that two that's actually over here? No. Problem with blowing that wall is this soldier becomes uncovered, which is not good. I think what I'm gonna do.
Heading there now.
Should use a different soldier to do that, actually. If I overwatch, that thing should counter overwatch me. Gives me a chance to deploy some troops out to flank it.
Moving to position.
I need to keep a lookout on that side too.
Yes, Commander.
When you love us.
Roger, I've got eyes on.
Roger that. Scanning.
Moving to position. On Overwatch.
Overwatch.
Je reste en observation.
Gaston, let's go with you.
Oh, he decided to fire. Okay, that's acceptable. Question is, where are all the other aliens? I need to take a look.
Okay.
Doesn't tell me anything. What if I were to blow this cover? Can't do it this turn. If I were to suppress it, then launch a flanking attack next turn. Four aliens left. If I can take that one out, three left. And then I can sort of fall back to this line and not have to worry about getting flanked. This is very bad. I need more sight. I think I have no choice but to do this. I just need to know where the other outsiders are. Okay, this flank seems clear. Suppress and flank?
Rolling.
That seems wise. without knowing exactly which way the aliens come, the dense smoke could backfire on me.
Come get some.
Got it covered.
Okay.
Aye, aye, Commander.
I'm on the move.
Two down. It's very good.
Got it covered.
Aye, aye, Commander. We're green to go.
I'm on it, Commander. Eyes on the prize.
Je vois l'œil, Commandant.
Okay, two down. Three to go, including the Super Outsider. Could they be? Well, they could definitely be on Overwatch.
Yes, Commander. Reloaded.
Heading out.
On Overwatch.
Roger that. Eyes on the prize.
Scan en cours.
They're wandering around outside, it looks like. Like the outsiders that they are. But they could very well be on Overwatch. And I don't want to dash up. That's pretty suicidal.
Moving
still, if I just, like, move into the line of sight, I should be okay. For good measure, I'll send, like, my soldiers who actually have a bit of health, including my officer. The carapace armor should protect her. Should be the operative word here.
Got it covered.
Come get some.
On it.
Gonna bring more explosives if necessary. Alright, let's take a look.
Roger that.
Interesting. I know one outsider is there. That might be where a second one is. Maybe this will lure them up? Although, if I lure them up, it'll be to flank me. There's just, like, no good way to approach them. Except maybe from the very periphery. That makes some sense. Actually makes a good deal of sense. If I sneak a couple of troops over this way, or maybe over this way, where I could potentially get a bit better cover, like behind these trees. Can I even reach these trees? No, I can't. This is really awkward. I think you have to move all the way up to the edge like this to see. It's just the one. Okay, I have a new plan.
That's affirmative.
I'm just gonna get everybody to line up on that ledge and shoot the outsider point blank.
Zadila.
And then throw a dense smoke to cover.
Reloaded.
Back in.
On peut y aller. Vous avez entendu?
Ah. Whoa. Okay. The turn I move away is the turn they move up here, and not too bad. Not too bad, little AI. Not too bad. But it's not gonna save them. First, let's see. Super Outsider still appears down there. There are two over here. Definitely vulnerable. Little sensing repositioning. Since I can kill one and then smoke and lock down the other one. And the Super Outsider is down there.
Firing rocket.
Sometimes you see this rocket bug where it doesn't do any damage. It doesn't matter in this case, but it's nevertheless really, really irritating.
Je vais vers la position.
Пора рисовать звездочки.
Can't move there.
Affirmative.
I'm not sure that would give me line of sight. I think this should. But for good measure, I'm just gonna dash my sniper over and see what exactly is going on. Okay. I know I saw a second outsider. But he's not here. I know I saw it. I don't know how to interpret this. I know I saw him.
That's affirmative.
Just gonna hold
That's
my position yet again.
Got it, cover overwatch. I'm on it.
Okay. Maybe he's coming through this direction now? And the AI is shifting its attack quite often.
Moving out.
Aye, aye.
Location confirmed.
Roger that.
Overwatch, aye, aye.
Okay, je surveille la zone.
Начинаю наблюдение.
Come get some. You hear that?
It's such an awkward way to make contact with the aliens. Looks like they're forcing me into some sort of assault, okay.
What was that?
Cat and mouse games with the outsiders. Ugh.
Rolling.
It looks like there might be some cover this way. I'm gonna send over my engineer and both rocketeers to scout out this direction. Keep the rest of my troops.
Roger, Dodger. Put.
Again, I don't know how to interpret these maneuvers by the outsiders. They're not doing anything, which, under the circumstances, is actually a pretty good move.
I'm on it. Affirmative. Covering down.
What's making that noise?
I wish the line of sight rules weren't so strange. Yeah, let's just dash here. Huh. I don't see anything. It's not good.
All an ass.
Actually, I'm gonna send my sniper down there. It makes the most sense. She might be able to get a good shot. Plus, she has low profile.
Rolling out.
I'm gonna shift my medic over in case they need dense smoke support. And I'm gonna keep you here. Watch out this flank.
Я уже там.
On the move.
Je vois
on overwatch.
What's making that noise?
Roger that.
I don't see anything. Not really a good sign.
I'm on the move.
Affirmative. I'm on it.
Actually, I'll keep you up
rolling
here.
Out.
Now that you can throw smoke in that direction.
Okay, je surveille la zone.
Hear that?
I think the outsider is right there. Oh, it's probably on Overwatch too. Okay.
On the move.
Oh, I can play that game too.
I'm on it.
On Overwatch.
Okay, je surveille la zone.
What was that sound?
Uh-huh. And this isn't the super outsider, this is the other regular outsider. After I kill this, are those squirrels? Aw, it's so adorable. I think those are squirrels. If I can kill this one, there's just a super outsider to deal with. Nicely done.
X-ray down.
Well, there's still the boss. But alone, without his minions, he is not too bad. Still, let's
position
take
confirmed.
A look. Where could he be? Could he be on the roof? Possibly.
That's affirmative.
Let's do this!
He does not appear to be in this direction.
Overwatch, aye aye.
Pareil!
Yes, sir. Буду на чеку. Reloaded!
It's killing time.
Okay, he must be hiding over there somewhere. Yeah, and I'm just gonna step
position
out to
confirmed.
Take a look. He must be all the way over in that corner, probably.
Слушаюсь.
Well, this is a good time to reposition my sniper, like right over there.
Location confirmed.
Oh, that's where the super outsider is! That's really bad. I have 3 turns to end this. Ugh. Man, the AI can be so sneaky sometimes. Plus it did like 7 damage, really? Well, now I know exactly where it is. This cat and mouse game is over. It is still kind of irritating to have that sniper crit. If only I had carapace armor, this wouldn't be a problem. Or a scout, this wouldn't be a problem, but...
That's affirmative.
I can't even jump down there. There's like no cover.
Moving to position.
On the watch. Missed.
I think that was a dash move.
Cover the flanks.
Well, I may actually have to stabilize my soldier the old-fashioned way. Yeah, that was a dash move.
Moving out.
Yeah, that outsider is not a trivial target to kill. Just because, like, when it's in a position like that, how do you, like, bait it? And it has too much health. There's no cover anywhere. This is like
moving to
really
designated position.
Probably should have made this map a little different. Like, this area, line of sight issues are problematic to say the least. Well, I can just run up and shoot me. He'll just run up to this cover. Like, this one guy can kill your squad all by himself. I'm not sure I'm gonna be able to stave the sniper. Just because I can't get there in time. I think by doing this, the AI doesn't have a good place to go. So I think it's likely to make a really suboptimal move. Yeah, like that. Okay. Okay, I have to kill the outsider this turn. Two shots at 92 are almost certainly better than one shot. But... Oh, you can't do that? Okay.
Yes, Commander.
Is there any way I can throw this without, like, killing my own soldier? Damn! I'm worried that, like, going down I won't have line of sight. I do have an AP grenade, which if used correctly might do the trick. Oh, I have flush. Okay. Yeah, this is where flush is gonna save me. Flush for the win.
Flushing target.
Flush for the win. And I save my sniper. Oh!
Mission accomplished.
33 aliens. This is actually a low number for this type of mission. So this was not an ambush. This was just a regular troop, probably a terror ship is what it was. Poor sniper. Critically wounded. You might go mech just because, like, on the other hand, look at the aim, but no will? Ah, so disappointing. I even think I gave her, like, some equipment to, like, promote her survivability. I can't remember exactly. But that's quite a shame. You were injured, but that's more or less to be expected. Since this is the covering fire type infantry, I think you gotta go lock and load, but we'll just survive, otherwise it's so good. But, despite some casualties, look at the loot. Corpses, whatever. 70 Illyrium, 70 alloys, 4 flight computers, of course, 4 power sources, and the alien stasis tanks and surgery. You need 12 of each to get a useful foundry project. I found stasis tanks seem to be more common, so I can sell off some of this, sell off all these artifacts, so much Illyrium and so much alloys. Ugh! And that Fino outsider, the hunt for that was... it was a very sneaky outsider, I had to admit. But yeah. Good stuff. I even got 2 Cyberdisk wrecks out of it. This is by far the hardest mission of its type at this point. So I'm a little tired from doing this video. I think the mission went very well. Moving the sniper was a calculated risk. I thought the outsider was further away, but realistically, if the outsider was just going to stay put there, there was no other way to have done that. Not really. I didn't have any flashbangs. If I had the 8-man squad, I could have brought a scout who I would use to do that, and the scout would have had a reasonable chance of evading that attack. It was close range. That's probably why the sniper got hit, and the sniper had so little health to begin with, but... it's okay, she lived, just has absolutely no will at all. Which is a problem, because the second hit will almost certainly kill her, but oh well. I'm actually surprised, only 28 days, that's nothing. Okay, thank you for watching.